but a slightly dimmer full moon at 1:40 a.m. just doesn't appeal.
You're not going to notice a thing.
You know.
I wouldn't even bother. No. But it is kind of interesting as to why does one eclipse really put on a show and another one doesn't.
Explain it all, Mr. Peck.
I'm just going to do it real quickly, and I've got a little diagram behind me that shows you how these things even happen in the first place. Go ahead and take that full screen, because you're going to see the Earth is right in the middle, and then you can kind of make out the moon there, which is spinning around. Well, we don't do, the moon does not go around on a perfectly flat plane. It's tilted, and you can see how there's two different shadows there. If you don't get right in the deepest part of the shadow there, as the moon goes around, you just barely kind of glimpse it on the side, and that's when you get a penumbral eclipse. And those are the ones that are not really, you're not going to notice much, but it's still kind of cool to know about it. Look at all the clouds. Those could also get in the way a bit, but they're not in the eastern sky, and they shouldn't be a major factor. Pretty view from Treasure Island right now, looking off towards the east. There's that moon from the top of the Tri-Valley. This is the camera above Dublin. All right, let's talk about these temperatures. We did it again this morning. We went back down into the low 30s, some spots even in the upper 20s, up in the shelter valleys up in Sonoma County. We're just going to keep doing that. It might get a little better tomorrow. We'll probably be like 1 degree warmer on the morning lows tomorrow from where we were today. But that, again, you're not going to notice much. Here are the morning lows for tomorrow. It'll be 31 in Santa Rosa, 33 for Petaluma and Sonoma. Colder numbers up here in the North Bay, but as we come down and check out the East Bay and the South Bay, it's going to be 36 in San Jose tomorrow morning. Upper 30s for Pleasanton, Livermore, San Ramon, and then look what happens. You get into the immediate bay, and it's only going to 44 in San Francisco. And the daytime highs are not changing either, low to mid-60s. We are locked in a pattern right now where we're not really thinking much about the weather, and that's a sign of how we're kind of digging ourselves a little bit of a hole here on the rain. We're already well behind. We've got about 25% of the amount of rainfall we should have gotten so far for this point in the season. And if you look off the coast, there are systems out there. One of them is going to bring some rain to northernmost California. And by Monday morning, you can see a really nice organized line of rain just off the coast, and then it just falls apart. We barely even notice the clouds from it. Maybe it gets a bit breezy around here as it kind of falls apart on Monday, but not like wind advisory breezy, no red flag warning, none of that stuff. It's just, it's really just a complete miss. And in the 7-day forecast, it just stays this way. Sunny, mid to upper 60s. No complaints if this is the weather you're stuck with. I mean, it is really nice in the afternoons. It gets cold in the mornings, and as long as you kind of get that drill down, you're kind of on autopilot. We're going to keep looking ahead to the next chance of rain. Right now, we can go out probably 2 weeks before we even see one, but that could change. More on that later.